One of the ways Ganondorf would disturb Hyrule's peace even before the Calamity was set loose on the Kingdom of Hyrule was the many monsters he's been able to influence to do his bidding. But there's one more important ally on Ganondorf's side, one that is more cunning, organized, and intelligent than any of the primitive beasts scattered around Hyrule, the Yiga clan. Today, we'll explore the role of the Yiga have played ever since the formation, the future goal in the sequel, as well as the conflicts that have been and are yet to come between the Yiga and the tribe they once belonged to, the Shika. So make sure to leave a like and subscribe as we take a look at the ancient and modern conflict between the White Shika and the militaristic Yiga clan.
The Shika. In ancient times, a united, strong, and highly developed civilization. Today, a weak, scattered, and divided one. In the distant past, they most likely had a crucial role in the sealing of Ganondorf and perhaps his mummification. A punishment far worse than death, as there was no way for the King of Evil to escape from the Seal of Eternity, as he couldn't die and then be reborn. This means that Li Chika members have been aware of Ganondorf's seal ever since they mummified him in the distant past, and that the Shika kept this information until and beyond the Great Shika Schism. After Ganondorf's sealing in the distant past, it is possible that over the span of at least the next 2,000 years, the Shika abandoned their primitive way of life, with dark magic to one that was based on technology and sophisticated weaponry that could protect Hyrule from Ganondorf and his puppets. At the same time, the ancient Shika also had a plan B in case their defenses failed, the Shika slates and hundreds of shrines to train and test the true hero who will face Ganondorf. Needless to say, it is from this era that all of the ancient Shika monks derive from and have remained in stasis until the time arrived to either hand Link a spirit orb or, in the case of Monk Mars Kosha, put Link in a final trial to see if he is the true hero Hyrule needs against Ganondorf.
All of these ancient Shika who sacrificed their own well-being for the sake of Hyrule's future were unaware of the events that transpired above ground, but knew that when they would be reawakened, it would be after the Divine Beasts. Link or Zelda failed in containing the beasts. 10,000 years ago, Ganondorf's creation and hatred, Calamity Ganon, was defeated with the Divine Beasts and Guardians of the Ancient Shika, and there was no need for the emergency plan B. Instead, the Ancient Shika could celebrate victory with the Hylians, Zora, Gorons, Rito, and Gerudo, but only for a while. Since, as the tapestry clearly shows, sometime after the threat of Calamity Ganon was gone, one of the kings of Hyrule aimed to put an end to the Shika's military might, which could potentially threaten the power of the royal family. Thus, he exiled the Shika from central Hyrule, a task that was easier to accomplish for the Hylian royal guard and soldiers, as the Shika were weakened after the Divine Beasts and Guardians had been concealed for preservation for the next Calamity.
The tribe was forced into exile in Kakariko and left with a choice to accept the new reality or fight for the tribe's honor and vengeance on the Hylians. In Kakariko, the Shika were surrounded and forced to become farmers, while in the desert, the remaining Shika, enraged by the Hylian betrayal, rearmed, held their ground, survived, and upon learning of the Kakariko Shika's betrayal, swore allegiance to Ganon. However, the tapestry isn't the only clue to the great betrayal, as Cardo of Kakariko elaborates in detail on the Great Schism in Breath of the Wild.
We of the Shika tribe have long been heralded as a people of great wisdom. Our technology became the key to sealing Ganon away during the Great Calamity some 10,000 years ago. At one point, our technology was praised as the power of the gods, but eventually, the people turned on it, turned on us. Our creations came to be viewed as a threat to the kingdom. The Shika became outcasts, forced into exile. Some, like us, chose to cast off our technological advances and strove to live normal lives. Others fostered hatred towards the kingdom that shunned them. These sad souls swore their allegiance to Ganon. They now call themselves the Yiga clan. Their sole mission is to eliminate all who stand against Ganon.
With all this in mind, we can pinpoint that the story of what would become the Yiga clan begins somewhere between the Calamity 10,000 years ago, and over time the goal was simple: resurrect Ganon and get rid of the Kingdom of Hyrule and its allies once and for all. This hatred for the royal family of Hyrule and its champions ran deep within the Yiga, and especially its leadership. While most races in Hyrule, including the Hylians themselves, forgot about the calamity of 10,000 years ago, the Yiga made sure to pass down the tale of Ganon and the subsequent betrayal by the royal family. Still, despite all their differences, where in many ways the Yiga was a Spartan society and the Sheik of Kakariko worked as an Athenian one, they did not confront one another. Was it because they shared the same blood, or perhaps both sides, despite their disagreements, respected the decision of the other? After all, what option did the Sheikha have other than flight or fight for their values? The Sheikha are no doubt the philosophical and scientific tribe of Hyrule, but through its attachment to ideals, it has always explored the unknown, and with it came technology that would both be a blessing and a curse which would end with the tribe's separation. As the Calamity 100 years drew closer and closer, the Yiga seemed to know more about Calamity Ganon than anyone else in Hyrule, with exception of the Kakariko and Castletown Sheikha. Urbosa even states that they are trying to revive Calamity Ganon. Their activity increased significantly as soon as the prophecy came to light. As the Hylians, with the help of the Sheikha, started preparing for the battle against Ganon, the Yiga started attempting to throw a wrench in their plans. Starting with a failed assassination attempt on Princess Zelda. This indicates that the Yiga are well aware that she's a key figure in defeating Calamity Ganon.
You may notice one thing though, the Sheikha may be aiding Hylians in the Yiga killing them, as they're hunting after Link and Zelda, but even faced by another Calamity, the two sides do not direct the blades towards the other Sheikha. The success of the Calamity changed this approach as the Kingdom of Hyrule ceased to exist. However, the Calamity was contained by Princess Zelda, and suspicion immediately fell on the Sheikha Kakariko for contributing to this state of matters. Before the Calamity, the most prominent Sheikha lived in Hyrule Castle and Town, but with the fall of the kingdom, the seat of the Sheikha once again returned to Kakariko. The Yiga then dispatched spies to get inside information from Impa, the caretaker of the village post-Calamity. In other words, the Yiga went from avoiding contact with the Kakariko Sheikha traitors to actively spying on them. This practice lasted for a number of years until a Yiga member named Dorian was sent out to collect information, but after some time instead fell in love. Creating a Champion elaborates further that Dorian fell in love with a local Kakariko Sheikha girl and made his decision to defect from the Yiga tribe to marry her. The lack of new updates alarmed the Yiga of what had transpired, but the clan waited before taking action until Dorian's wife gave birth to two children. The plan of the Yiga was simple: kill Dorian's wife as punishment to terrorize him and then use his children as hostages to keep Dorian in his place as a gatekeeper spy. The Yiga plan worked, and Dorian even admits that he told the Yiga about Link and the information about Kakariko Village in return for the safety of his children. However, at one point Dorian had enough, and felt he owed it to his wife to protect his children from the Yiga. He no longer feared them, and was ready to confront them at the next possible occasion. The Yiga, however, were pure evil, and threatened to kill both Impa and her granddaughter Baya if Dorian didn't follow their orders. Luckily for Dorian, he was saved from this horrible fate by Link, who had taken care of Master Kogha. So here we are, the Yiga spying on the Sheikha, the Yiga murdering Dorian's wife of the Sheikha, the innocent Kakariko inhabitants, the Yiga threatening Dorian with killing his children. In addition, you have the Yiga hunting Link before and after Master Kogha's death, the Yiga threatening Dorian with killing Impa and Pyre, and Link saving Dorian from certain death at the hands of a Yiga Blade Master.
Going into Breath of the Wild 2, Link and Dorian have become close friends and allies. They both share the same dislike for the Yiga, as they are constantly targeted by them, and they respect one another. Link for Dorian's hardship, and Dorian for Link's privacy in keeping his Yiga past a secret to everybody. However, there is one Sheikha that is unaware of the current state of affairs, Monk Mars Koshia, who is still deep under the Resurrection Shrine waiting for Link and Zelda to return and probably tell them about Ganondorf and where he is kept sealed. There's only one issue in the puzzle, the Yiga clan. Despite being a master of ancient Sheikha combat techniques and similar fondness of bananas, Monk Mars Koshia has no knowledge of the Sheikha schism and that a descendant clan of the Sheikha's best warriors aims to aid Ganon against the true hero of Hyrule. Luckily for everyone involved, nearly all Yiga missions have ended in complete failure due to Link. He, who protected Zelda in the desert 100 years ago, defeated all of the Yiga assassins sent to kill him in the present, single-handedly infiltrated the Yiga clan hideout, and defeated Master Koga, and then defeated all Blade Masters including the one sent to kill Dorian. Yes, The Yiga are a joke of a military force without leadership to succeed whenever Link is in the way. So it might be that they simply stay away, but only until Ganondorf is resurrected and takes command over the Yiga clan, turning dedicated morons into deadly warriors and the most feared enemy in Breath of the Wild 2. With the Kingdom of Hyrule gone, Ganondorf will no doubt set his target on the Sheikah, who are Link and Zelda's closest allies and his worst enemy. They possibly sealed him, built a divine beast aimed to destroy his calamities, and inflicted defeat upon defeat until the Great Calamity 100 years ago. A free Ganondorf, however, needs allies, and based on all the humiliation and Sheikah help to Link and Zelda, the Yiga clan would be the perfect fit. The Yiga clan, once keeping the Kakariko Sheikah out of their plans, might strike their real enemy, which aided the Kingdom of Hyrule numerous times, helped Link with restoring his memories, directed him to the Divine Beasts, offered him ancient Sheikah weaponry, all to bring the blood of the goddess Princess Zelda back and destroy the Calamity. In doing so, they also brought Link to the Yiga clan, and from the Yiga point of view, Link killed Master Koga in battle, and then prevented a Yiga Blade Master from killing Dorian for his treachery. The motivation to go after the Sheikah, whose aim is to help Princess Zelda restore Hyrule to its former glory, is definitely there, and the seeds of war have been planted following the incidents in Kakariko and the Yiga clan hideout. The Yiga will be ready for war as soon as Ganondorf returns and is ready to take command. And in the light of all of this, the minor confrontation between Dorian and the Blade Master will pale in comparison with the battles that might take place between the Sheikah and the Yiga in Breath of the Wild 2. Sadly for the Sheikah, it appears that Ganondorf's return couldn't come at a worse moment, as the reveal trailer shows that all ancient Sheikah technology and structures are gone, and with that goes potential ancient Sheikah weaponry that they could have used against Ganondorf and the Yiga. If this turns out to be true, the path to Ganondorf will be soaked with Sheikah blood, and sooner rather than later, the Kakariko Sheikah will militarize against Ganondorf and the Yiga and face them on the battlefield. Most likely culminating in central Hyrule, as the Yiga, much like Xant and the Twi'li in Twilight Princess, are certain to block the pathway to Ganondorf. Perhaps as mini-bosses or even main-bosses, but if there's one way that Nintendo can truly impress us, than it is with a full-blown gameplay-based battle in central Hyrule, of a scale we have only seen in references, art, and cutscenes in a long list of past Zelda games. Summing up, it is possible that the Sheikah Schism that took place after the Calamity 10,000 years ago might finally result in a Sheikah-Yiga clash in Breath of the Wild 2, as the two factions finally face one another. We got a hint of this tension in Breath of the Wild, and with Dorian seeking vengeance for his dead wife and ruined life, we wouldn't be surprised that we see him and the other Sheikah in an important but also tragic role, that of sacrifice, but also heroism, to rid Hyrule of evil and win back the peace. That is how you develop the Sheikah and the Yiga tragic side plot of Dorian in Breath of the Wild into the greatest Zelda story which is waiting to be told in the sequel. Or at least, that is what we're hoping for. So what do you think? Do you agree with this assessment? Or do you think Nintendo will not take advantage of the great Sheikah vs Yiga foundation and build up they established in Breath of the Wild? We want to see your opinion in the comments section down below. And if you haven't already, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, and press that shiny notification bell for all notifications if you haven't already. Finally, a big thanks as always goes to all our great patrons on patreon.com/commonrail. We hope you can join them there or by pressing the join button next to the subscribe button to become a member sponsor of the realm. Anyways, we'll see you in the next video.